Today on The Journey, we're going to talk about Google Analytics, what it is, and how to set it up for your business. People talk about Google Analytics all the time because it is the best. If you have a website, you should sign up for Google Analytics. What it is, it's a tracking token that you get to put on your website, and then it gives you so much information about the people who are coming to your website, what pages they're visiting, when they're coming, how they're coming. And the best part about it, it's free.
I like free.
Mm-hmm. All right, so first step, we're gonna go to google.com/analytics. Mm-hmm. And then we need to sign up for an analytics account. All right, so it's gonna bring you to this landing page. Hit sign up. So we're just gonna name this one Morgan Test for my test website. And then you can choose to share your data with a variety of things. I'm just gonna unclick those right now. It's up to you. And then click next. Since we're setting this up for our website, we're going to click we want to measure web. The next thing that we need to do is we need to put in all the information about our website. So we gave this an account a name, and now we need to specifically call the website name. So this website is called upskill.life, and we're just going to use the same thing, upskill.life. So this is actually one of Neely's accounts that we're going to be setting up for him. I think it's the beauty and fitness. So pick an industry category, and then you can obviously put your time zone and then hit create. So now that your account is set up, the very first page that it brings you is your tracking ID. This is the most important step. Just because you created an account does not mean that suddenly Google is going to start tracking your website. You actually have to do something with the code that it generates. So right here, very top front and center, it lets you know that this is your code. But you don't just copy and paste this code. You actually need this code all the way down here, this script. So what you're going to go to do is you're going to put that on your website. Every website is different. WordPress has areas that you can do it. Depending on your theme, you might have to add a plugin, but it's best to go and look at your website's documentation to see how to add the Google Analytics code.
So after that, then I'm good?
In theory, it may take 24 to 48 hours to propagate. So that's why you can come back here to the status just to keep checking. And right now it says no data received, so because we haven't put it on anything, but it will say you're good. I have a site we can go into that has traffic and has the code. It's been there for a long time. So let's go check out one of my other sites. So this main page, this kind of gives you a snapshot of everything that you're seeing. So right now you can see that there's one active user on this site. You can see over the past few days, more or less how many users have been there, page views, bounce rate, and just some other statistics where they're coming by country, when's your hottest hours. So these are other reports that give you even more granular data about the people who are coming to your website. So this first one is real time. So if you can click right here, you'll see the number of people active on your site right now or over the past 30, 60 minutes. You can see where they're coming from. Just one person who's been to this site recently, but you can drill it down based on location, traffic sources, where they're coming from. But what's more important is your audience in general. Yes, you can see a snapshot in time, but I love to go to the audience tab and then go to overview, where I can see over a longer period of time how many people have been coming to my site. So the first thing that I like to do, this is just showing the past week. Mm-hmm. That's helpful, but let's go back in time. Let's just look at 2019 as a whole, just to see.
Yeah, 1 week doesn't give you a lot of information.
Yeah, and you may want to just look at a quarter or a month, but you can see bigger trends over time. So the default, it's going to default to users. I like to also look at page views. And then it also has some other just high level statistics for this period, which is great. You can see total number of page views, the average number of pages per session, number of sessions, and so on, how long they're staying on average, and then the bounce rate. So the next big category, which is one that I love, is acquisition. This is where are your customers finding you? And I always like to do overview first because, again, it's just a dashboard that has all of the metrics in one place. And then, of course, you can always drill down.
This would be able to help you to redirect how you're using all of your time. Like if you get more on social, then you know where to spend more of your time and, you know, promoting your business.
Yeah. Or if you don't have very many people coming organically, it's probably an opportunity that you're not ranking in search. Mm-hmm. And so you need to probably do more SEO. Another category is behavior. So once they're on your website, what are they doing? Mm-hmm. So let's click on the behavior tab and go to the overview. So you can see, and we've kind of talked about these on the high level overview, you know, how many pages are they viewing, the average page time, bounce rate, but you can actually see where they're spending the majority of their time, on which pages, if you go right here to behavior flow, you can kind of see a mapping of how a customer is going through your website. As you get more familiar with Google Analytics and you're using it more and more for your business, there may be certain aspects of the different reports that you love seeing and others that just aren't really valuable to you. So you can go to the customization section and then create custom dashboards and views. So that way when you log in, you see the most important things and then you can go back to doing what you do best. All right, that's everything Google Analytics. I hope you found it useful. Let me know in the comments below what your favorite piece of data is to track using Google Analytics. I'm interested. Is it page views? Is it users? Is it traffic sources? Let me know.
And make sure that you like, subscribe, and ring that bell so you know when we have new content coming out. This is The Journey. We'll see you next time.